What's up, guys? It's Kelly, and today I am doing 5 different holographic nail art tutorials for you. I'm partnering up with Starrily for this, and we are using all Starrily polishes. You guys know they have some super gorgeous holos, so let's just go ahead and get started, and I'll show you all the looks. So we're gonna start off with the first look, which is this really fun checkerboard design. For this look, you're gonna need some base coat. I am using Starrily Galaxy Gang and Starrily Stargazer, both part of collabs with Starrily that I've done. You're also going to need a thick glossy top coat as well as some striping tape. So I'm going to start off with my clean natural nail and add my base coat. And once that's dry, I'm going to go in with my base color. So I am using Starrily Galaxy Gang as a base because this one is more opaque, whereas the other color is kind of a jelly. So this is going to be a really good base to put some nail art over. And as you can see, this is a one coater. So I'm just doing one coat on my nails. But if you're using a less opaque polish, you'll want to use two. So once that's dry, I'm going to go in with a nice thick glossy top coat, and I'm doing this to protect the base color from getting peeled up from using my striping tape. So you want to make sure that's totally dry, and then you can cut up some of your striping tape. And what I'm going to do, it's kind of interesting. So I'm not putting the tape on the direct center of my nail. I'm putting it slightly off center because the tape is going to be covering part of the design that is going to show up. So in this case, we're actually including the part underneath the tape as part of that other box. I know that's really hard to explain, and I'm probably not making much sense right now, but if you go slightly off center, you're going to see that the part that you're covering, that's going to be part of the design later. So just doing everything just slightly off center, and I'm actually leaving a tiny bit of space in the middle so that the two diagonal boxes can actually connect with each other, because that's just going to make it look a little bit more seamless. So now I'm taking the color Stargazer and a tiny little brush, and I'm going to be filling in the larger two boxes. So I am going diagonally, and like I said, this is the part of the nail that's going to be, this is like half of the nail, what I'm doing right now. So once I peel up the tape, you'll see that the other half of the nail that I didn't paint also includes the stuff that's under the tape. Again, so hard to explain. I'm not even sure if I'm explaining this correctly. You'll understand once I peel off the tape. So we want to work super quickly here, making sure that you are filling in the area very quickly. And then once that color is on, you want to make sure to peel off the tape while it's still wet. Now for me, it's a lot easier to peel up the tape in the order that I put it down. So I always peel up the last piece that I put down first and then go in reverse order. And that just makes it easier, so there's no like weird pulling or tearing or anything like that. So when you're working quickly with striping tape, sometimes you're gonna mess up your cuticles a little bit. So I am just taking a small little cleanup brush and some pure acetone, and I am just cleaning up any weird lines or anything like that. And then I'm gonna go in with my top coat once more, and I'm gonna seal in that design and just make it look really beautiful and complete. So that is the first design. I absolutely love this one, mostly because I'm using two of my favorite polishes of all time in combination with each other. And you guys know how much I love purple, but it's really fun because we get that really soft scattered holo from Galaxy Gang, and then we get that really loud like chunky holo glitter from Stargazer, so it's just a really fun combo. So the next design is this really sort of vampy V-shaped almost claw nail. I had the hardest time capturing the holo on this, but I can assure you it is super holographic in real life. So for this one, I'm going to be using my base coat, Starrily Cosmic Voyage, which is another one of my collab shades, and Norepinephrine, which is a really beautiful red holo. I'm also going to be using their top coat as well as some striping tape once more. So I'm going to start off with my clean natural nail and apply my base coat. And then once that's dry, I'm going to go in with a couple of coats of Cosmic Voyage. Now you can use whatever base color you want in the background. For this, I wanted it to be a black background with a red V, so it almost kind of looks like claws. For me, it was hard to decide whether I should use just a regular plain black cream in the background or if I should use something that had a little bit of extra scattered holo in it. And for me, I just ended up using Cosmic Voyage because it has this really beautiful subtle red shimmer in it as well, and I think that just kind of highlights the red that's in the nail art, so I thought it would be a really cool combo. Anyway, I'm going to go in once again with some top coat, and again I'm just protecting that base color from getting peeled up from the tape. So now I'm just going to use the striping tape to create a long V on my nails, and you can also use regular tape for this, but I find striping tape is a little less tacky. And then I'm going to take take some of that gorgeous red nail polish and another little nail art brush, and I'm gonna fill in the inside of the V. So this V-shaped manicure is something that I do all the time, especially around Halloween, because I think it looks so cool and it almost looks like claws, like I've said like 50 times already. But one of the most important parts for me is to make sure that the tape goes all the way down to the end of the nail. So you don't actually want the two pieces of tape to intersect on your nail. You want them to intersect slightly after so that you get that nice point at the exact edge of your nail. So then I'm just going to peel up that striping tape while the nail polish is still wet to make sure I have a nice clean line. And then I am going to finish off with some top coat once again. And yeah, that's the full look. Like I said, I had a really hard time capturing the holo on this just because it was nighttime and I was in indirect lighting and it's a little difficult, but they both are super holographic, and in the sunlight, this would be so insanely sparkly. Next up, we have a super classic look, and that is the glitter gradient featuring some gorgeous holo glitter. So for this one, again, I'm using my base coat, Starrily Vanta Black, and Starrily Luna, which is another one of my collab shades because I'm a little biased, but I think they're amazing. I'm also going to be using some top coat. So once more, we start off with our clean natural nail and we apply a nice coat of base coat. And then once that's dry, I'm going to go in with Starrily Vanta Black, and that is going to be my base for this manicure. This is the only nail polish in this video that is not holographic, but I think it just creates a really nice effect for having that glitter pop over such a beautiful one coat black nail polish. Once that's dry, I'm going to go in with a tiny little cosmetic sponge and my glitter, and I'm going to start at the very tip of my nail and slowly work my way up sponging. So with the color Luna, we have a really nice chunky glitter, which makes it so easy to decide whether you want the glitter to be super sparse or if you want it to be super dramatic. And just the amount of tapping that you do on your nail, you can kind of decide how far and how crazy you want that glitter to go. I also like to do a little tiny bit of dabbing on just to make sure that some of those glitters get in spots that might seem a little bit more sparse, and also just make it more of an even little glitter gradient. Once you're satisfied with how that looks, you can go ahead and add a nice thick coat of glossy top coat, and this is going to both seal in that design, and it's also going to flatten out those layers of glitter that you've got on your nail. And that is the final look. I totally love this one. Again, super holographic, super sparkly, and I love the way that it combines with like a dark nail polish, like a black or a navy blue or a really rich dark purple, and I just think it looks really cool. Next up, I'm going to be showing you this really fun polka dot nail art design. This is almost like advanced polka dots. So for this look, I'm going to be using my base coat, Starrily Diamond Rain, Starrily Magic Rainbow, and Starrily Cat Eyes, which are all beautiful holographic shades, as well as their top coat, a dotting tool, and optionally you can use a tiny little brush as well. So I know this is a huge surprise, but we're going to start off with our clean natural nail and apply our base coat. Once that's dry, I'm going to go in with a coat of Diamond Rain. So you definitely want to make sure that your base color is fully opaque. So if you are not using a one coat nail polish like I am using, you'll definitely want to throw on a second coat of color. Now I'm just gonna take my two polka dot colors and I'm gonna put them out on a little piece of paper or a silicone mat, and I'm gonna start the dotting process. Now when you're doing alternating dot colors like this, it's a little bit more complicated and you have to kind of wipe off the dotting tool in between. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with one color and I'm gonna do it in the middle of my nail on the top. And then I'm going to go in and I'm gonna start doing three dots across each line, and every other dot is gonna be a different color. So what I'm doing is one on the left, one on the right, and then one in the center below the last dot. And then I'm gonna wipe off the brush and I'm gonna do it again. So I know it's really confusing again to just say out loud, but if you can see how I'm doing the process. And then another little alternate step is I like to draw on little half circles with a tiny brush on the edges of my nails just to kind of complete the design. You can always do this with a dotting tool if you want. I just think it's a little bit more precise when I use a tiny little brush and there's less cleanup to do because you don't have the rest of your dot somewhere on your skin that you need to wipe off. If for whatever reason you do, you can always wipe that off with some acetone. And then I'm just gonna go in with my top coat once more, and I have finished up that design. So this is another one that doesn't look as holographic on camera, but it is so super bright, and all of the holographic different types of holo in there just shine together and it makes it look really cool. And last but not least, we have a holographic gradient. You guys know gradients are my go-to, so I absolutely had to include one in this tutorial. I am going to be using Base Coat, Starrily Magic Rainbow, Starrily Cat Eyes, and Starrily Blue Rose for my gradient, all linear holographic shades. I'm also going to be using their beautiful top coat. So once more, we're gonna start off with our clean natural nail and apply our base coat. Once that's dry, I'm gonna go in with a couple of coats of my lightest of the polishes that I'm gonna be gradienting with. So you always wanna start with the lightest color because the lighter colors won't show up on darker colors. So you wanna start off with the lightest and work your way to the darkest. What I'm doing is I'm gonna have the lightest color at the top and the darkest color at the tip of my nail. So today I am just using tape because I am out of liquid latex, but you can also use liquid latex, whatever you want to protect your skin. So I'm just gonna take a little cosmetic sponge and I'm gonna do a nice thick coat of that lightest nail polish on the top, and then I'm going to move down and do, like I said, really thick overlapping lines of those other colors. And you can see just how much I'm putting on this sponge. We're using a lot of color here because we want enough of it to saturate the sponge so that it actually comes off on the nail instead of actually peeling up that base color, which can sometimes happen if you don't use enough polish on the sponge. I'm just going to go ahead and sponge it until I am satisfied with how it looked. For me, it took about 2 coats to do this, and you can always replenish your sponge with some more nail polish if you need to. And then I'm just going to peel off this annoying tape, and I'm going to use acetone and a cleanup brush to get any bits that the tape didn't cover. And then once that is totally done, I'm going to go in with a nice thick coat of top coat, and that is it for this manicure. And that is it for all of the manicures in this video. Let me know which of these is your favorite. This one I absolutely love because I think it's really interesting when you sponge on linear holographic polishes, they tend to turn into like a scattered holographic polish. Now, I felt like this was absolutely not showing enough holo, and I happened to do this one during the day, so I am showing you guys a little peek of what it looks like in direct sunlight so you can see just how much brighter and more holo stuff gets when you got it in direct light or direct sunlight. So, like I said, that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments which is your fave. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, please consider subscribing, and I'll talk to you all later. Bye!